Hello there, Gamers Gunner here, and welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario Bros. 2! Last time, we finished World 6 with the Princess Mario and Luigi, and now we're going to start World 7 with Toad. Which, believe it or not, I think is actually the last world in the game. So, if this goes well, you can easily see who's going to be fighting the final boss. That's right, you wouldn't have expected this character back then to be fighting a final boss, would you? Nope, I bet you didn't. I can't remember, is the mushroom here? I think I'll forego that mushroom actually. Because we're just gonna get continuously bombarded with bob-ombs. So yeah, I'll just take the power block. Just to be safe, because it's really gotten to that point where I don't want to start risking going for things that I don't need. Oh, we have Asian plants! Okay. Right. Don't one of these have... yeah, here we go. So, is the mushroom in here? Yes, it is. There it is. Awesome. I will take the coins. And just for the hell of it, I'll pull up all these other plants. Ooh, you Sparkies are looking a bit blue today. But that will give me a chance to run all the way back. What? Why run all the way back? Aren't you normally supposed to go all the way to the right in these old classic NES games? Well, yeah. But in this case, going left is the way to go. And we have to take the birds and come over this way. Because yeah, I bet when everyone first played this game, you wouldn't have even known to go all the way to the left, did you? Don't worry, I was the same. If anyone says, oh, okay, I knew that I had to go to the left back then they're probably lying. Okay. Now, I'm not really a big fan of this area, to be honest. Because, we have Sniffits, we have Shy Guys, we have Ninjies. So yeah, this level can be pretty dangerous. And it's times like this I wish the Superstar had infinite usage, I think. Well, that didn't go very well. Oh, damn it, I was so close and I had to stop in the middle of a Sniffit. But I've got plenty of lives, as long as I don't waste them, then I should be okay. Okay, that was not good. Yeah, let's kill as many enemies as I can so I have a high chance of seeing a heart appear. Well, there's a star. I'll gladly take it. But I'm gonna have to bolt it. Like Usain Bolt. The fastest runner in the world. That's what I would like to see. A Mario game like this, but it's got like what'd you call them? Olympians? You know, as the characters? You probably have a character like Usain Bolt as the one who can run the fastest. Oops. So yeah, this area, not my favourite, as I said before. Of course, it's challenging, but you know, we have to deal with all of these, and yeah, we also have to make our way up at the same time. So it can be very, very annoying! And there's a heart right there. So yeah, I need to remember I cannot throw the mushroom blocks whilst I am underneath another mushroom block. So there we go, if I do that, and then, there we go. Right. Now if I jump, there we go. Okay. There we go. See, Toad's good at dodging bullets. Okay, Birdo time. Damn, if I was quick enough, I could have managed to defeat Birdo without Birdo even getting a shot off. How the hell do you respawn? Fine then. But still, it wouldn't have really done much good if I went and fought Birdo again. Okay, so we only succeeded once in this one. Okay, well, it looks like the princess is going to be the one finishing the game for us. So, let's go. Let's finish this game, shall we? Now, I don't think that we can... I'm pretty sure if you had Luigi, you could probably get up there, but there's nothing really up there anyway. So I don't even know why I bother trying. Okay, here we go. We have conveyor belts. Lovely. We have spikes, we have ninjas, we have shy guys. We have the whole nine yards. Oh yes, and we also have ball bombs as well. Now, I think we have to come down this way. It's going to take me a while to remember how to get through this, actually, so please bear with me. Right, get rid of you, because you're a fast one. If you know the actual way to go, then you can grab all these cherries on the way down. But I'll just stick with one side. I'm not really one for, like, changing direction. Okay. Oops, I should have kept going. But we have plenty of lives, so I'm not too fussed about it. Oh yeah, I think this is where we can get a mushroom. Yes indeedy, so this will help us a lot. And for the hell of it, we can take a coin, even though I don't think we can actually gamble. Oops, yeah, I don't think we can actually gamble once this level's done, actually. Okay, so now I'm gonna have to kill some things in order to get that heart back. Okay. Oops. I was getting home to grab that cherry, so I was hoping that a star would flow up, so that way I could kill some enemies and get a heart back. But apparently not. Didn't go that way. Right, now just wait. Go. Wait. Oops. Didn't want that happening, but okay. Wait. Go. God damn it, I am not doing this very well today. Okay, well there's the star, and it's not coming out from the wall. To be honest, I don't even know why I even grabbed those cherries. I should have known. If the walls are that close together, then there's no way I'm gonna get it, because the star's just gonna appear from within the wall. Go. So, yeah. Okay, now we have something which reminds me of the old arcade of Donkey Kong. Except this time, it's like conveyors. And we have to do a high jump like that. Yes. We have to high jump, well, kind of flash as we're moving along. And then quickly jump near the end. But we made it. Birdo! Now, I know there is a Birdo somewhere, but I don't think it's this one, actually. Yikes. Right, I'll just wait till you spit your eggs and fire. Right, grab that egg. Right, little Birdo spits. Go! Yeah, it's not this Birdo. There's a heart there! Lovely, but it's through the wall. But yeah, there's another Birdo here that actually has something that we need. Yeah, there's a key, and that Birdo has that key. But I can't remember what Birdo it is. Oh, there it is, right there. Oops. Come on, I would like your key, please. I want to get into your house and so I can steal things. Holy moly! Oh boy, this ain't good. Right, come on. Come on. Wait, wait for it to spit the eggs and fire. Okay, there we go. No, get back here. Yeah, imagine that. Only the keys will actually fit through the doors. And that is a very, very bad place for the key to land. So yeah, I'm gonna have to fight Birdo for the key again. You know, I think I've actually made this a lot more difficult than I should have now that the princess is the one gonna be finishing this game. Okay, grab the key, through the door, take a big run up. Okay, there we go. That's more like it. Okay, let's get through this door. Okay, no Birdo today, since we've already fought two of them. But we are fighting a bird! It's none other than the exit face. Ah! So yeah, this thing can be pretty tough. So I think what I'm gonna do is bring these mushroom blocks over and then get ready. There we go. One. Pick it up, princess. Two. Float over there. Grab that. Gotcha! Okay, here we go, guys. Final boss of the game. Meet Wart. Now, the way to beat Wart is that apparently he doesn't like vegetables. So what you're supposed to do is wait till his mouth opens and then throw the vegetables in. But unfortunately, these bubbles he's spitting out kind of disintegrate the vegetables. So what I like to do is once I've got a vegetable is run up behind him and then throw the vegetables in. Yes, apparently you can throw vegetables into Wart's mouth from his back. And to be honest, when I first played this, I actually thought that you actually could only damage him from the back. It wasn't until I like watched other LPs of this that I found out that you actually had to throw the vegetables into his mouth. And I didn't even know that. So yeah, you learn something new. And when you throw the vegetables in the back, it kind of negates the bubbles that he's spitting out. Come on, Wart, vegetables are good for you. You know? You should eat your vegetables. Weren't you taught that as a kid? You know, always eat your greens. Right, come on, a few more hits should do it. And you don't have to worry about these fanos, okay? They're just here for decoration. Okay. Oh hey, we done it! Whee! So yeah, well done! We have done it! Well done, princess! Sorry, you can't take your vegetable with you. Alright, let's get out of here. And we save 8 of these little flying things. But don't worry, we will know the names of everything by the end of the game. Well, kinda during the credits. And there we go, so if you played the way I have done, you will notice that everyone gets a combined score of 5555. So there we go, we have all contributed. Absolutely awesome. But, a big shocker for everyone. It was all just a dream. That's right. It was all inside Mario's head. But it was a good dream. I wouldn't mind having that kind of dream. So yeah, while Mario was safely tucked away in his bed, he was dreaming of adventures. So let's have a look at the cast, shall we? Well, we have our heroes, we have Mario, Luigi, Princess, and Toad. And of course we have all our monsters as well, so while the cast is going up, I think I will start to talk about even though this is near the end of the game. Yes, I will talk a bit about my experiences with this game. So yeah, as I said before, the first version of this I ever played was the Super Nintendo version from the Mario All-Stars game. I actually do like this game, you know, even though that a lot of people don't actually kind of class it as a true Mario game, I think it is good as its own little game, you know, for what it is, you know, I think it's kind of nice. Oh yeah, and just so I can join the little group, Birdo and Austro, names have been switched. Yeah, Austro is supposed to be the ostrich. Okay. So, Claw Glip. Yeah, they spelled that wrong. But yeah, it was Claw Grip, I think it's supposed to be. And of course, we have the big dirty wart. So, yeah, it's a very good game, you know? I really do like it for what it is, even though it's kind of a reskin of the Japanese game Doki Doki Panic. You know, I'll still give it a 10 out of 10. It's very, very awesome. I really liked it as a kid, and I still like it now. You know? Even though I know some people like to call it as the black sheep of the series, but, you know, I like it for what it is, you know? At least it's not a bad game like the Mario CDI games, you know, like Hotel Mario and that, you know, even though I've never played them, but I have seen gameplay of them, and yeah. I mean, even games like Mario is Missing is better than the CDI games. So, yeah, I have enjoyed this game to the fullest. I absolutely enjoy it. I will be planning on doing Super Mario Bros. 3. So, yeah, so when, I don't know, probably sometime in the future, so keep an eye out for that. Now, I don't know when I'm going to be starting my next LP, because one, I don't know what I'm going to be doing, and two, obviously, I'll be really busy with college and stuff, so it might be a while before I upload anything. So, yeah, so don't worry about it, I haven't quit, I haven't given up Let's Playing, so yeah, just be patient. As for the face cam stuff, I have actually enjoyed it. I think I might continually put these into my LPs, and we'll see how it goes. Even though that I know facecam is usually more popular with games like horror games and live streams and that, but yeah, I think I'll keep them around for a bit, and we'll see how it goes from there. So, I guess I'll close this off now. So, thank you guys very much for watching. If you've liked this Let's Play, you can obviously like it. If you didn't, then go ahead and dislike it. If you really liked it, and you want to stay tuned to the channel and be part of the Gondor team and show your support, then you can hit that subscribe button and, you know, just keep an eye out for my content that way. So, thank you very much for watching. Goodbye from me. Goodbye from all the Mario cast. Cheerio. And keep on rocking.